Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today I wanted to put you on to some new plugins. So this is called UVI Falcon, and we're loading up what are called Soundware. So basically think of it like Contact. Falcon is like Contact. Soundware are like Contact libraries. And also in Falcon, you could load up what are called effects. So they make their own effects that you could load up in here as well. Whereas in Contact, you would have to load it up through a plugin called Reactor. So nobody talks about this. I have no idea why. Apparently this is up for 2 years. I had no clue. So this company is one of those slept on companies. They have the best product, but they're under marketed, definitely. So this is called the Sonic Pass. The way I found it, I was looking for a sound library on their website, and I was debating if I wanted to buy it for the full price. And I clicked on two different libraries, and on the second library, I saw this thing that said Sonic Pass. Let me see if I can find it here. It was like a big thing that says Sonic Pass on it. So I was like, let me see what Sonic Pass is about. So it made it affordable, is what I'm saying, to gain access to these super high-priced plugins. And so the first thing I downloaded was Falcon under the Sonic Pass. It's a paid program, so I paid for it. It's way cheaper than buying the stuff straight out. So get Falcon, and then basically I downloaded Soundware from all these retro synths. So it's synths that I've sampled in real life. I flew up to Canada to sample super rare synths, like the Chroma. I'm surprised they actually have the Chroma. The Memory Moog, the... just super old stuff, the PPG, just really rare old synths. And they have a lot of those in these libraries. So Falcon is the only company that I would say is better than Arturia. As far as their analog sound, in my opinion, this is the actual sound of analog. Again, I've been to Canada, I've been to hear these synths in real life, and this sounds like the actual thing. So let's go to Chroma, for example, one of my favorite synths of all time. Again, I play the real thing. I even sampled the real synths in my plugin called Hercules. So if you go to my plugin at BusyWorksBeats.com/Hercules, you'll find in the Hercules a lot of analog sounds. Just analog just hits different, okay? It just resonates different. So here's the Chroma, for example. You can feel how sturdy that sound is. The only word I could really use for it is like a sturdy, steady sound. And it also, it resonates in like the middle of our head. That's the one thing about analog that I've never heard from digital, is it's like it taps into our brain, in the middle of our brain, and it just like stays there. It's like a weird thing. I don't know what it is though. Okay, so let's stack up some melodies here. So far it's at 3 CPU. I think if you use multiple instances of Falcon, it gets a little CPU heavy from last time I tested. So what I like to do instead of just stacking up multiple Falcons is load up, hit this plus button. Now again, I gotta warn the beginners, Falcon is not for beginners. Like if you're trying to click around and try to figure your way around Falcon, it's impossible as a beginner. Even for a sound designer who's seasoned at stuff, it's probably one of the most complex interfaces out. That's probably why a lot of people kind of don't mess with it, but it's under marketed because it has the best sound. So that's like the trade-off. It's like, that's the trade-off, but they're, you know, they make the best sound I've heard so far. So we're going to click over here, and we're going to click here where it says the MIDI channel and switch this to Omni. So you should see an A with an asterisk. Okay. Then we're going to add another layer, and let's do more brass sounds, for example. So now we're loading up multiple instances of the Chroma, and then we can click here, go to Omni, and now we're layering the sounds. And you can quickly lower the octave, for example, on one layer. So let me lower this down. Let's do one more octave down just so you guys can really hear the difference. And now you have a custom sound. Now I wouldn't play chords layering octaves like that, but we can even, let's do it this way. Let's make this, so this is my chord code, for example, 04, and let's add another one. Let's see if we could duplicate. Okay, I tried to right click and duplicate, but let's add another layer, and let's do, so they have really rare synths. So the Chroma, the Memory Moogs, the OBX, it looks like, the Yamaha DX7. They had to rename it for copyright purposes, but I'm pretty sure those are the synths they like modeled after. the Prophet Synths. Okay, so let's do the Yamaha stuff. Let's do a brass. And again, I have the real synths that I actually use for sound design, so I know what these sound like. Actually, this might not be a Yamaha DX7. Okay, let's do this, and let's make this a 7. So this is a major chord every time I hit a key. Actually, let's do this. Let's go to Omni. I forgot to... So now each sound is playing a different note, and they stack up. So this is why chord codes are so important. I can't say minor third, major fourth. You have to know semitone values, and this is where my chord codes came from. So if you don't know chord codes, go to busyworksbeats.com/musictheory. I teach you how to make chords from number instead of just memorizing scales all day long. And this is the magic of it, because now we can apply it to our sound design. So let's make this 11. So now every time I hit a key, it's playing a major seventh chord. And all the different instruments are playing one of those notes. Let's add another layer, and then let's make this a... I'm going to switch it to a minor ninth because it's a little more jazz sounding. So let's add another horn. So far, so good. The CPU's not going crazy. Okay, let's do this on Omni, and let's switch this to 14, which would be the... So it's 0, 4, 7, 11, 14, which makes the major ninth. Major ninth. Let's switch this to a minor, however, by changing our third and our seventh to 3 and 10. So now it's going to play a minor ninth chord. So the unique sound is that every sound is playing a different note. Get those Wiz Khalifa type. So it's a unique way to think about sound. And again, this company does it so well that it's scarily good. Okay, and I sampled the real deal synths inside of my new plugin called Hercules at busyworksbeats.com/Hercules. I went up to Canada. You can check my Instagram because I have highlights of when we went up to Canada and sampled all these rare synths. So I went in about the sound design. My favorite patches from this are the bass for the most part. And okay, so let's go to Falcon. Let's start from scratch. Let me see if we could clear the multi. I'm not sure. I never did this clearing the multi. Let's click up here, clear multi. So we start from scratch. Okay, so let's make a little melody and then we'll wrap this video. So let's do some bell layer. Let's do top line, which is bell. Turn this on. So we're at 96 BPM. Let's turn this down. Now this time around, I'm not going to layer the sounds because I don't know how to separate MIDI channels on my MIDI controller. Okay, let's make it simple. Let's load up another Falcon. Let's start stress testing it to see how many instances of Falcon we could use before the system blows up. Okay, let's add a flute. So this is all FM stuff. FM was like synthesis designed to sound like real instruments. Okay, so we could also use... How do we go monophonic on here? I don't... Let's do edit. Let's do mono mode. So now it slurs. Let's do that again. That was kind of... So one thing I'm going to do here in FL, we have to go to the cog icon, go to your pitch range, pull this up. So now we can do pitch slides, and I'm not going to use the mod wheel for this one. Let's just add this in. Let me practice a synth line real quick. So far, it's a unique, it grabs the ear. I might add more layers to the bell. add more layers to this bell, see how. Switch out this bell sound, it's a little. So now we're at 35 CPU, whereas before it was at like 6 to 10. So when we start stacking up different instances of Falcon, that's when it gets a little CPU heavy, which means we wouldn't be able to play stuff in real time. Like my buffer length is at 1280, which I forgot I even moved the buffer length up. But if I move this down, let's say to 128, which is like a normal recording buffer length for producers, let's see if we get crackles and pops. Add a pad in here. See that crackle and pop? You can even see the jitter in the CPU. So here's where you're gonna, that's why it's hard to recommend plugins when you know what. So for example, when you buy these plugins, you think you could load up 10 and just play in real time. But in reality, when you start putting your hands on the keyboard and realizing that your CPU is maxing out, you can only really load up like 2 plugins. So it gets a little taxing at that point. You're either gonna have to render it to audio or do everything in one plugin instance. So this is where we're stress testing it, and we can see this is the point where it starts to get a little heavy on CPU. And my computer's pretty good. I can't imagine somebody whose computer's not that great. So the pad is super clean. Okay, so now we have a bounce. Let's add one more layer for contrast. Let's see how far we could take this. I like the bell, but So let's see if we can squeeze another Falcon instance in here. This is where, again, it's starting to get a little heavy on CPU. And again, if you had drums and a bunch of mixing plugins, your session would just blow up. It would crackle the entire way through. So this is the only struggle with plugins that are this powerful, is that it requires a lot of power as well. So our computers haven't matched up to like really handle these plugins yet. And that's the biggest thing that I've seen hold back some of these companies who are like ahead of their time. So the UVI company, again, great company. It's just the stress test is what really kind of shows. But I will say their customer service is super fast. They helped me and they were super straightforward with it. So again, great company, just under-marketed. I think if they pair up with like a lot more content creators, they'll do way, way, way better. Because right now, nobody talks about this company because it's their hidden gem. So if everybody's keeping it a secret, how are you gonna really market it? This. switch out that first bell because it has like an Asian type sound to it. I just don't want that ethnic type sound. I just want a straight bell. Let's see what we can find. Without any drums. Here's one of my favorite things to do. I'll combine all these, hit Control G, go to the left side here, right click, go to transpose, and then we could drop it down a couple keys with the negative sign or pull it up a couple keys with the positive value. So let's pull it down 3 keys. Keys, so we need to do positive 6. I don't really like that key as much. I definitely like the lower key though. So let's play it one more time. So go check out the UVI Falcon. Again, super, super slept on. Just wanted to share with you guys. Subscribe if you're new. And if you want to check out my new plugin called Hercules, go to busyworksbeats.com/Hercules. I sampled a lot of dope synths, and this is all my sound design. I'll see you guys over there. Peace.